The first thing you need to be careful is about the framing. Now if I just hold like this, this doesn't make any sense. If I hold like this, this doesn't make any sense because there is a lot of distractive elements over here. Now what I'll do is just observe how you need to take these kind of images very nicely and very neatly. Let's say this is my framing. As you can see, there is a river stream over here and there are a lot of leaves grown. It just goes to the depth and follows the river stream. That's how it's gonna look. And just if I capture it normally, this is the normal user interface of the camera. Just if you open the camera, this is what you'll find. And if I just click a picture, all right? So as you can see now, everything is pretty much sharp and in focus, right? And there is this focus missing over here because I did not use the tap to focus, and it rather thought that this is the proper thing to focus, and the focus distance is over here right now. Now how you can avoid this and get some really good looking images, just look at this. There is this wide aperture mode, as you can see. Just if you tap on that once, wide aperture enabled. So once you frame this thing properly, just go ahead and click a picture and boom, there you go. Now as you will see with the images I've taken, the leaves is pretty much sharp, and with that said, the rest of the thing is completely blurred, guys. This is awesome feature that's available on the 7a or rather other Honor phones as well. And there is this, when you go to the gallery, open this same image, there is this mark over here, wide aperture. That means it says you have captured with the wide aperture enabled. And if you again just click on that, here you can see how much ever you want, you can pretty much blur the background completely. So if I increase the aperture mode here, just where you want to focus, again you can refocus that. And after that, if you save the image, now you will see that pretty much everything is out of focus. So that's blur, background blur, and this is very very sharp. So this is how you capture the image with the wide aperture enabled. Very much useful for capturing portrait shots or even the close-up images of subjects like this. Alright, let's shift to the next image. I'll show you next setting. So guys, the next setting that I'm going to show you here is if you just swipe right like this, here's the HDR mode. Now already you probably know how to use the HDR mode, but still in brief I would say that, just a tip, do not use HDR while capturing persons' faces. So HDR is used pretty much to capture landscape images, so that way it covers all the shades of highlights over here as well as shadows. So this way HDR gives you really nice images. It rather captures three images, stacks itself, and gives you one single image with all the dynamic range covered in a single image. So that's when you use the HDR and not while capturing any person's faces. So keep that in mind. That's the HDR mode here. Again, if I swipe right, there's this watermark. So you can add your own watermark, which is really awesome. Not really you'll find in many phones nowadays. You only have the option of writing the dual camera setup from that particular brand. But in the Honor 7a, you can give your name as the watermark. So as you can see here, there are other settings here. If you just click on next, so there are variety of options as watermark. You can use it while capturing images. So there are others to load as well. So just say that I want to use this watermark. So what I'm going to do is, if you just tap on I am here, here you will find you can give your name. So let's say if I just type in the name here and press on tick mark, so it asks for the swift key keyboard. Alright, so here's the watermark. So here's the watermark of ourselves. You can use your name, and here's the temperature and other information as well. So this is how you use the watermark on a Honor 7a. And another setting here is to look at is the filter. So there are, as you guys know already, there's live filter available. So you can browse through the filters and use that whichever you find it very interesting. So again, if I just swipe right like this, if the filter mode is enabled, if you just tap on that again, it will get disabled. Otherwise, you can always tap this cross mark. There is also this settings here, as you can see, if you just tap on this, you'll have the filter level set. So you can pretty much set the filter level on your, based on your liking. So if you want to just disable this filter, just tap on cross mark and then it gets disabled. Next one thing, an important thing I'll show you here is inside the settings. If you just swipe right like this, here you'll find all the settings. So one by one, the first one is the resolution. As you guys know, resolution changes the aspect ratio and also decreases the image size. So there is 10 megapixel at 1:1 aspect ratio. If I just tap on 1:1 aspect ratio and click a picture, this way without losing any frame you can actually share your pictures on Instagram very instantly. So you don't have to post crop the image in order to share it on Instagram. So that's a very useful feature. And again, if I swipe left like this, there's the resolution. There is 18:9, which covers full view. So if you want full view, there's this 18:9 at 9 megapixel. As you can see, 18:9 aspect ratio image is here. And if I again swipe right like this, there is this 18:9 at 5 megapixel as well. Say that you want to share your images and there's not really much space left, so you can always capture with less megapixel pictures. So there is this 13 megapixel at 4:3 aspect ratio. The another setting here is GPS tag. If you want to enable location, you can always do that. There is this assistive grid. So there are four options here. I always suggest you to use this grid option, which is really important. This enables you to take the pictures with proper horizontal level. As you can see, if I hold like this, this is not the proper professional angle to capture pictures. So what you have to do is make sure everything is level to the horizontal and then click a picture. Use this assistive grid as a reference line. That's really important. The another thing here is mute. So if you don't want that shutter sound, you can always mute that. There's this timer over here, this audio control. So these settings works while you are capturing video. Say that you are shooting a video and you want to control the audio, you can always use this meter here. There is touch to capture. So if I just enable this, if I just touch on tap to focus and again press, so you don't have to even press at all. In Xiaomi phones, you should rather tap to focus and then press again. But here, it just focuses automatically and captures images for you, which is really awesome. And there is a capture smile. So if somebody is smiling, it takes pictures. Touch and hold. If you just touch and hold the shutter button, it takes burst images. So more than one image, say around 10 images in a couple of seconds. That's awesome. So one important awesome feature on the Honor phones is the ultra snapshot. So as you can see, what this does is open camera and take quick snapshot. Say that I just lock the phone now. If I just double press this volume button, say I press this volume button, make sure you frame where you want to take the image and then just double press this one. So the camera opens and captures your image in rather just 1 second. So how cool is that? So you don't miss, somebody is going, you want to quickly capture the image, just use the volume button twice and instantly it captures the image, which is really awesome feature on this Honor 7.
Been stupid silence, you've been standing right there all alone, even though it's been unspoken so long. I'm only waiting for you, just waiting for you to give it enough. You know I'm begging for you, just waiting for you to show me your love. I wanna be certain, we don't need to be lonely, we don't have to be hurting, cause I'm feeling like you and I are perfect. I don't wanna be sorry, I don't wanna think every night about how we've been so blind. So sad, I'm waiting till it's too late. No rest for lovers who are undetermined. I just wanna be certain, I don't wanna waste all our time wondering if we're right. I've been waiting for a sign, wanna make you part of mine. I've been waiting for a sign, I don't want you going away. I've been waiting for a sign, wanna make you part of mine. I've been waiting for a sign. Don't you feel the same? You want it for us, even though you don't wanna say it. I've been saying it softly, with no words. You whisper with your just waiting for you to give it enough.
Give it enough. Give it enough.
No, I'm begging for you, just waiting for you to show me your love.
Show me your love,
baby.
Show me your love.
Cause I wanna be certain. We don't have to be lonely. We don't have to be hurting. Cause I'm feeling like you and I are perfect. I don't wanna be sorry. I don't wanna think every night about how we've been so blind.
So upset,
I've waited till it's too late. No rest for lovers who are undetermined. I just wanna be certain. I don't wanna waste all our time wondering if we're right. I've been waiting for a sign. Wanna make you part of mine. I've been waiting for a sign. I don't want you going away. I've been waiting for a sign. Wanna make you part of mine. I've been waiting for a sign. Don't you feel the same?